So what he's going to try to do, he's going to try and spin underneath me like a normal reverse Tadahiva in hopes of taking my back, sweeping me. It's a very common position. So I need to understand what I need to do before he gets in there. One thing that he needs to do is this grip. It's very common. He tries to bring his hand underneath my shin. So my hand over here is going to block him at the knee, so that if he tries to bring his leg over, I'm constantly blocking him with my elbow. I also need to keep his head from going in between my legs. So I'm going to control it with this grip over here. All right? I can get it when he starts spinning, and I can get it before. The point is, when he does start spinning, it's all in this knee over here. As he begins to spin, I need to turn my knee out. All right? So as he goes, I do this and sit down. Once I've done that, I can bring my other knee to get rid of his arm and end up in this half guard-like position. But I'm not going to allow him to lock his half guard. I'm going to keep dragging his leg, almost straightening it, to the point where he doesn't have any leverage. And from here, I just windshield wiper my foot out and then walk back into him using that same grip I had on his hips to take side control. All right, so again, he has his hand in front of my shin and he wants to spin underneath me. I need to control his hips and my other hand controls the collar. The most important detail is my timing with my knee. As he starts spinning, I need to take my weight off of my knee and turn it out. So as he spins, this is my position. As I land, I can now allow my other knee to get in the way of his arm because I don't want him to keep holding onto my leg. Once I'm here, I'm not going to let him close half guard either. I'm going to keep dragging his leg, straightening it over here. And now my foot is just going to windshield out of the way, and now I'm going to use my saber to turn his hips and go to side control.